Okay students, good morning. Today we are going to discuss the isomerism in complexes, which is extremely important topic from our exam point of view, and you will definitely find the questions which are being asked on this particular topic. So let us start with this topic called isomerism in coordination complexes. Isomerism in coordination complexes is distributed in two parts basically. First is called as structural isomerism, whereas another is called as stereoisomerism. Now you know the basic difference between structural isomerism and stereoisomerism. Say for example, I take this CH3 CH2 CH double bond CH2, and I take this compound CH3 CH double bond CH, and this is CH3. Everybody knows that this is but1-in, this is but2-in. Molecular formula is same, but structures are different, right? So these two isomers we can consider it as structural isomers of one another. But you know this particular compound but2-in. But2-in can be written in two ways: hydrogen on one side, CH3 on one side, and carbon-carbon double bond, hydrogen on opposite side, and CH3 also is on opposite side. Now, when we write same compound in two different geometries, we consider its three-dimensional arrangement. So they are stereoisomers of one another. We know it is cis, it is trans. So stereoisomerism always considers 3D arrangement, whereas structural isomerism always contains a 2D arrangement of the molecule. So structural isomers, stereoisomers of same compound. Okay, so now we are going to focus on structural isomerism. So structural isomerism, if you see in coordination complexes, I can split it into four different parts, structural isomerism. So let me write structural isomers one below another. Number one, first one is called as ionization isomerism. Second one is called as coordination isomerism. Third one is called as linkage isomerism. And fourth one is called as hydrate isomerism or solvate isomerism. It is also called as solvate isomerism. So we are going to take it one by one. Now let us discuss ionization isomerism first. First is ionization isomerism. Ionization isomerism, we are going to discuss it. Now ionization isomerism, for that matter, if I take a simple complex, cobalt, NH3 5 times, Cl, and counter ion is here sulfate, and another complex CO, NH3 5 times, sulfate is acting as ligand, whereas chlorine is coming out as a counter ion. Now here, when anionic ligand can act as counter ion and counter ion can act as potential ligand, then such type of isomers which are obtained, they are called as ionization isomerism. Ionization isomerism is very simple, students. Suppose I take this complex and I put it in water. You will find that this entity is floating and sulfate ions are released in the aqueous solution. If you take this particular complex and if you add it in water, you will find that this entity is floating and chloride ions will be in the aqueous solution. So this complex gives me sulfate ion and this complex gives me chloride ion. You can test these. Now suppose for this sulfate ion, we can say if I add barium chloride solution in this particular complex, so barium chloride will react with sulfate ions to form the precipitate of BaSO4. Precipitate of BaSO4. So this particular complex will give you the positive test for barium chloride. Now same barium chloride, if you add it in this complex, nothing is going to happen for barium chloride. It will not be giving any precipitate. But suppose you add here AgNO3 solution, silver nitrate solution, you will find that Ag can combine with Cl to form AgCl, which is white precipitate. So chloride ion can be tested by AgNO3 and sulfate ion can be tested by BaCl2, both of them with 1:1 proportion. So ionization isomers ki simple definition hai boss. Kya? When counter ion acts as potential ligands and ligands can act as counter ions, the complexes or the isomers which are obtained, they are called as ionization isomers or ionization isomerism. Now one very important thing, let me tell you about this. What kind of questions are being asked in examination? Anionic ligand काउंटर आयन बन सकता है, काउंटर आयन अनायनिक लिगैंड बन सकते हैं, ये तो हमको अच्छी तरह से मालूम हो गया है अभी। न्यूट्रल मॉलिक्यूल्स कभी भी बाहर जाते नहीं है, वो अलग टाइप का आइसोमेरिज्म है न्यूट्रल मॉलिक्यूल के साथ में, लेकिन अनायंस जब एक्सचेंज हो जाएंगे अंदर बाहर तो दे आर कमिंग अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ आयनाइजेशन आइसोमेरिज्म। अब जेईई में हमारे कौन से क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं, मैं आपको सिंपल क्वेश्चन पूछता हूँ, ये याद रखना है आपको 1:1 प्रोपोर्शन, इसका आपने भी याद रखना है। नाउ सपोज a compound having one cobalt, five NH3 and three chlorine. A compound having molecular formula one cobalt, five NH3, three chlorine, when reacted with AgNO3 solution, it gives 2 moles of AgCl. If it is giving me 2 moles of AgCl, what is the correct formula of the compound? So you will be given options. Option A, first option will be given CO NH3 4 times Cl Cl2 NH3. B, CO NH3 5 times Cl Cl2. Option C, CO NH3 5 times Cl2 Cl, and option D, none. In solving such type of questions, one should not forget that coordination number of metal should be 6, because cobalt is forming octahedral geometry compounds. So here we can find it is 5 and it is 1, 6, here it is 4 and 5, here it is 5 and 2, 7. So in one stroke some students can give the answer that this is my correct answer. But what if suppose somebody is giving me this option, it is 6 and it is only 1. Now here you can find out AgNO3 is giving me 2 moles of AgCl. 2 moles of AgCl means if you take the complex and if you add it in water, you should get 2 chloride ions, because AgNO3 reacts with chloride ions in 1:1 proportion. So suppose 2 moles are given, that means we are adding 2 moles of AgNO3. So naturally our answer is this one. So 2 chloride means 2 moles, 3 chloride means 3 moles, 1 chloride means 1 mole, and 0 chloride means 0 mole. So this is the answer for this particular compound. I hope you understood this ionization isomerism.